Very good morning, students. Yes, today we are going to start the next chapter in a grammar part. Yes, that is voice. The page number in your textbook is in 76. Page number is 76. You can turn to page number 76 and listen to voice. Yes, we have completed unit 1 and unit 2. In unit 3 we have completed the first prose in celebration of being alive, and the poem All the World's Stage. After completing this area, we are giving importance to the next grammar topic in unit 3, that is voice. Yes, I already told you the page number is 76. Okay, let me start the topic first. Yes, from the lower class onwards, you have been still learning voice. Yes, can anyone answer what is voice? Yes, very good. Voice means importance. What do you mean by voice? Voice means importance. Voice means what? Voice means importance. Yes, according to importance, as per voice, the term has been classified into two categories. Yes, they are active voice and passive voice. Clear? So listen, what is the meaning of the term voice? Voice means importance. Voice means importance. In grammar, as per the meaning, the term has been classified into two. They are active voice and passive voice. Clear? Let me teach you what is an active voice and what is a passive voice first. Clear? Active voice means doer importance. What is an active voice? Active voice means doer importance. Who is a doer? A person, one who is doing a work. Clear? He is called what? Doer. What do you mean by doer? A person, one who is doing a work, is called a doer, or one has done a work, that is called a doer. Passive voice means action importance. What is a passive voice? Passive voice means action importance. Action important in the sense that what is the work done by the person, that is a doer. If the importance given to the subject, given to the person, is called active voice. If the importance falls to the an action, that is what? An active passive voice. Let me give an example. Listen. I write a letter. Clear? I write a letter. See, in this sentence, I, the subject, write the verb, a letter is an object. A letter is an object. Clear? I write a letter. See, whenever we are given a sentence, what's the first work of? We have to do the sentence pattern first. That is, we have to find the subject, verb and object. Clear? The next thing that, see here, I write a letter. Who is writing letter? The person. I write a letter. So, the important is there on the subject. I write a letter. So, that importance is where? On the subject. So, that this is what an active voice. Clear? See the passive voice. Yeah. Letter is written by me. A letter is written by me. In this sentence, the second sentence, this is what sentence A, this is what sentence B. Clear? In sentence A, I write a letter, the importance falls on the subject. Whereas in sentence B, the same sentence has been converted into passive voice. See here, the importance falls on the main verb is written. See here, this is right, but here it is converted as a is written. A letter is written by me. Clear? So the importance falls on the verb. That is an action. Clear? So that this is what a passive voice. See? A, V. You know, acts, you should know that is an active verb, active voice. If it is a PV, what's that? Yes, passive voice. So what is voice? Voice means importance. Voice means importance. As for importance, in grammar, the term voice has been classified into two types. What are they? Active voice and passive voice. What do you mean by active voice? That is what do your importance. If the importance given to the subject, that the person, one has done the work, that is called active voice. Passive voice means if the importance falls on the action, that is what passive voice. Clear? Okay. Let us go to the next one, that is the conversion of active voice into passive voice. Listen, conversion. You know what is that? Changing. Changing what? Active to passive voice. Active voice to passive voice, or a passive voice to active voice. Active to passive or passive to active. See here, for converting active sentence into passive or passive into active, we are following 5 steps. Clear? How many steps are we following? We are following 5 steps. Listen, the step number 1. The step number 1, what's it? Yes? What's it? Yes. Object is placed. Object is placed as a subject. Object is placed as a subject. Step number 2. After the step number 1, we are going to step number 2. What's step number 2? According to the tense and numbers. Numbers means, yes, singular and plural. According to the tense and number, an auxiliary design should be introduced. Listen, what's step number 1? Object is placed as a subject. Step number 2, according to the tense and numbers, an auxiliary design should be introduced. Then step number 3. Third main verb. Third form of the main verb should be introduced. Okay, then fourth step, preposition by is introduced. Then step number 5, yes, subject is placed as a subject is placed as an object. See, these are the 5 steps we are following. Clear? Step number 1, object is placed as subject. Step number 2, according to the tense and numbers, an auxiliary design should be introduced. Step number 3, third form of the main verb. Okay, third form of the main verb should be introduced. Fourth step, preposition by is introduced. Fifth step, subject is placed as an object. See, clear? These are the 5 steps we are following for what? Converting or changing an active to passive or passive to active. These are the 5 steps. And here, let me go for another rule. Okay, you have to remember these 5 steps. Then only you can get a good mark. Listen. Step number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Clear. Very, very important for converting active to passive. Clear. The next, let me go for the second step. See, according to the tense and number, this is very, very important. Clear. For the second step, exclusively for the second step, we have another rule, that is a tenses. Okay, listen. For converting active voice into passive voice, we should know very well about the tenses. Okay, we know in the previous classes I have taught you that the tenses, there are 12 tenses in English grammar, but in a voice section 8 tenses will be functioning. Clear? Only 8 tenses will be functioning. This is exclusively for the step number 2. Clear? See what the step number 2 says. Step number 2 says that according to the tense and numbers, tense, yes, those 12 tenses, but here we are using only 8 tenses and numbers, singular and plural. Okay, listen. Next rule. See, serial number, tenses, singular, plural. See step number 1, sorry, see number 1, simple present. Simple present. If the tense is simple present, the auxiliary, if it is simple present singular, the auxiliary is plural, that is are. Tense number 2, present continuous. Present continuous singular. What's an auxiliary? Is being. Plural or being. Clear? Then tenses number 3. Present perfect. Present perfect singular. What's it? Has been. Plural, have been. Clear? Then present perfect continuous, here the fourth tense that will not be functioning in voice, so that we can move to simple past. Simple past singular, the auxiliary is was. If it is a plural, the auxiliary is were. Tense number 5, past continuous. If it is a past continuous singular, was being. Plural, were being. Tense number 6, past perfect. past perfect tense, past perfect singular had been, plural also had been, clear? Then seventh tense, simple future, simple future singular shall or will plus be plus third main verb. The same thing for plural also, shall or will plus be plus third form of the main verb. Clear? Then tense number 8, future perfect tense. For future perfect tense, what's the singular auxiliary? We can use shall or will plus have plus been plus third main verb. The same thing for plural also, shall or will plus have plus been plus third main verb. Clear? These are the 8 tenses and it's a singular plural form in for converting active into passive voice. Clear? See, in the first rule I told you the first 5 steps, that is the conversion of active into passive, what are the basic steps we have to do. Okay, in that basic steps, the second rule, according to the tense and numbers, for that rule we are having a tabular column, that is a another rule in tenses. See, simple present, numbers in the sense that singular or plural. Clear? See, tense, simple present. If it is a singular, we have to use is as an auxiliary. Simple present, plural, we have to use are as an auxiliary. Present continuous, singular, is being, plural, are being. Present perfect singular, we have to use has been, in plural, have been. Simple past singular, we have to use was, plural, we have to use were. Past continuous, was being, were being. Past perfect, had been, had been. In case of simple future, in singular and plural, shall or will plus be plus verb third form. For future perfect tense, what will be the singular or plural? Both are same. Shall or will plus have been third form of the main verb. See, you have to remember these things. Very, very important. See, this is what passive form of tenses. Clear, students? You should have remember these things. If you do not know this rule, you will be losing your mark. Clear? You can write it down in your notebook and read these rules. Clear? And in step number 1, I told you 5 conversions. In another rule, there are 8 tenses. Already I told you in grammar we have 12 tenses, except present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous, future continuous, future perfect continuous tense. These are the 4 tenses which are not functioning in voice. Remaining 8 tenses will be functioning. Clear? Yes. Let us move to the next rule, that is a in case of pronoun. Okay, change of pronoun. You know that there are 7 pronouns: subjective pronoun. What are they? I, we, you, he, she, it,
they. Why it is called subjunctive pronoun? Because these pronouns will come in the place of subject. Then in conversion of, that is a objective pronoun, clear, I will be changed as what? I becomes me, we becomes us, you, yes, you, he, him, she, her, it, it, they, them. Don't forget, this is another step. In case of a subjective pronoun, if you are supposed to change into an objective place, if subject is I, that is in a fifth step, okay? Subject has to be placed as a, subject is placed as a object. For the fifth step, okay, if the subject is I, you have to change it into me, we, us, you, you, he, him, she, her, it, they, them. See, this is what the change of pronoun, the change of pronoun. Clear? See, in the beginning, I told you, what do you mean by voice? Voice means importance. In importance, there are two types of importance according to the grammar voice. What are they? Doer importance, action importance. If the importance is on a doer, that is what? Active voice. If the importance is on the action, that is what? Passive voice. Next, I taught you conversion of active to passive or passive to active. We should do five steps. We should follow five steps. Okay, what's the step number one? Object should be placed as a subject. Step number two, according to the tense and number, an auxiliary design should be introduced. Step number three, third main verb should be introduced. Step number four, preposition by should be introduced. Step number five, subject has to be placed as an object. Clear? For the second step, that is a tense and numbers, I taught the previous changes, that is a tenses and a singular and plural. Then fifth step, we have to follow this rule. Okay, these are all the basic rules we have to remember while converting an active into active sentence into passive. Okay, listen. See, for converting active voice into passive voice, you will be given 2 marks. Clear? And now, see, types of passive. Types of passive. What are the passive forms? First one, single object passive. Second one, double object passive. Third one, command passive. Fourth one, question passive. Fifth one, auxiliary passive. Single object passive, double object passive, command passive, question passive, auxiliary passive, then dummy object passive. Seventh one, passive with additional information. Passive with additional information. These are the 7 types of passive forms we have. Clear? What's the first 2 passive? Single object passive. Second passive, double object passive. Third one, command passive. फोर्थ वन कोसिन पैसिव, फिफ्थ वन एक्सिलरी पैसिव, सिक्स्थ वन डम्मी ऑब्जेक्ट पैसिव, सेवन्थ वन पैसिव विथ अडिशनल इंफॉर्मेशन. दीज आर ऑल द सेवन पैसिव फॉर्म्स और सेवन पैसिव टाइप्स इन इंग्लिश ग्रामर. क्लियर? वी विल बी डीलिंग विथ वन बाय वन दीज टाइप्स ऑफ पैसिव. हाउ डू वी कन्वर्ट सिंगल टू सिंगल ऑब्जेक्ट और डबल ऑब्जेक्ट इन टू अदर पैसिव अदर वॉइस. ओके, लेट मी स्टार्ट विथ दी सिंगल ऑब्जेक्ट पैसिव. Yes. What do you mean by single object passive? Yes. A given sentence. Okay. A given active sentence. If it is having only one object. Only one object. That is what a single object passive. Clear? For example. He posted a letter. He posted a letter. The first important rule, very most important rule for converting an active into passive or passive into active, any type of voices. What is the most important rule? The first rule is that you have to do sentence pattern. You have to do sentence pattern first. Yes. He subject posted verb a letter object. Why it is very very important to do the sentence pattern? Because for converting an active into passive or passive into active, we must in need of an object first. For converting an active into passive, we must have an object. Okay. If a sentence does not have an object, it is not possible. Just listen. He posted a letter. In this sentence, what's the important thing? As I have already told you that, yes, we have to find the object first. Why it is very very important? Because an active sentence must have an object to convert active into passive. Clear? If a sentence does not have an object, that is not easy to convert, that is not able to convert into passive voice. Why? Because the verb should be a transitive verb. The verb should be a transitive verb. Okay. So, a verb must have an object, then only that verb could be converted into passive. Clear? See, here posted and we have a verb, or we have an object. What is an object? Yes, a word which gives answer for what. See, he posted a letter. What did he post? What did he post? He posted a letter, so that this is what an object. It gives answer for what. And the sentence has an object, so that this is what a transitive verb. Clear? See, in this sentence, he goes to Salem. In this sentence, we do not have any object. So that this verb is a what? Intransitive verb. So for converting an active to passive, the verb must be transitive. Clear? The verb must be transitive. So that I advised you, first you have to find an object. See, now listen, as per the step number one, object should be placed as subject. Yeah? Letter. As the beginning letter should be in the capital, so that A. And according to tense and number, step number 2, according to tense and number, the tense, that is in a simple past tense, and a letter is a singular. Simple past singular, what's an auxiliary? Was. Clear? You have to remember and by heart the tense formula. The letter was. Then third main verb, post, poster, posted. The letter was posted. Then fourth step, preposition by should be introduced. And the fifth step, subject should be placed as an object. What subject here? He. In objective pronoun, it should be converted as a him. Clear? So a letter was posted by him. See, in this sentence, we have only one object, so that this is what? Single object passive. If we have only one object, we can write only one passive. Clear? Now we move to the second one. Double object passive. Double object passive, which means a sentence which has a two objects. See, he gifted. He gifted me a pen. He gifted me a pen. See, already told you we have to do sentence pattern. He, subject, gifted, verb, a pen. A pen. He gifted a pen. What did he gift? A pen. So that this is what an object. This is what an object, or we can mark it as a direct object. Direct object. And to whom it was gifted? Me. So the word which gives answer for whom, whom, whom. That is what indirect object. Clear? He gifted me a pen. So in this sentence we have two objects, so that we could write two passives by using direct object at first. See, a pen, happened, singular, tense, simple past tense. Simple past tense singular, yes, was. The pen was. Step number 1 is over, step number 2 is over, step number 3, main verb of the third form of the main verb. Gift, gifted, gifted. A pen was gifted. Gifted by him to me. That's all. Then step number, sorry, again another answer. This is what a another one answer for passive voice by using direct object. Now we are going to use indirect object. My, if it is in the subject place, my should be written as a I. I, simple past and singular, so that was. I was gifted a pen by him. That's all. See, for writing double object passive, you have to write two answers. In, if possible, you can write, you are expected to write only one answer. You can follow any one. Whether, either you can write a indirect object answer or a direct object, that's your choice. Clear? So this is what a double object passive. Clear? See, single object passive means we can write only one passive. Then the sense that we are having only one object. Then double object passive means we have two objects and we can able to write two passives. Clear? And now we move to discuss command passive. What's it? Yes. Command passive. Command passive is nothing but it's a imperative sentences. What's it? You see, in single object passive or double object passive, we saw this. Yes. What's it? Statements. Okay. Declarative sentence. An ordinary sentence. But here, command passive. Command passive, that the sentence which is an imperative, which means that The sentence can ask us, the sentence give us order, command, pleasing, suggesting, advising, okay, warning. These are called imperative sentence. See, imperative sentence we can write in command, there are two. Yes, positive command, which means do the work, and a negative command, which means not do. Do the work or not do the work. So there are two types of command, positive command or negative command. Clear? See, if it is a positive command, how should we write the passive form? Listen, for a positive sentence, what should be the passive form? Let plus object plus, let plus object plus be plus third form of the main verb. This is what the positive command, passive form. Okay, the next negative command passive form, let plus object plus not plus be plus third main verb. This is what negative command passive forms. This is what the positive command passive form, negative command passive form. Okay, let us see in an example. See, read the last page. Read the last page. This is a command. And what does this mean? Read the last page. This is what you are asked to do the work. You are asked to do the work. The sense that positive command. See, in command sentence, you could not find the subject because it is straightly given to the second person. You could understand that the subject is you. So in writing command, no need of writing subjects. See, this is what the verb and the object, and also this is what a positive command, so that we should write this formula. So what will be the passive form? Let person object, the last page, the let the last page, then we should write be, let the last page be third form. Read, 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 the same spelling. That's all the answer. Clear? Now see the next one. Don't read the last page. See here, this is what a negative command. So that what should be the answer? Let the last page, let the last page not be read. This is what the negative form. This is the positive, this is the negative. See, in command, if it is in a command, and if it is a requested, you can write. See, for commanding passive, for command passive, your answers may be following this method, and another method is also there. Okay, for an example, open the door. Instead following this method, you can also follow an another method. What's it? See, already I told you, in a imperative sentence you could not find any subject, but you should understand that the subject is you. Clear? So open the door, I asked you, okay, to open the door. So this is what positive, and open the door, I request you to open the door. So this is what the, yes, excuse or request. You are requested to open the door. Okay. See, and another one. Don't open the door. See, this is a positive, this is negative. You are requested not to open the door. Clear? This is what the command passive. You can follow two methods, either let by write by starting with let, or you can follow this one. You are requested. According to the sentence, according to the situation, if it is an order, you are ordered, you are requested, you are pleased, you are advised, okay, you are suggested, like that. You can start the sentence according to the situation. Otherwise, you can either follow this one. Okay, in command, there are two types of command, positive command, negative command. You can go by two methods, either let command, let method, or you are this method. Clear? Yes. What we have seen today, I taught you what is voice, and as per the meaning, there are two types of voice, active and passive. Active means doer importance, passive means action importance. Then conversion of active to passive, you are following 5 steps. For the second step and third step, I have given you 2 rules, that is a tense and singular verb, singular tense and plural tense, and conversion of subjective pronoun to objective pronoun, and types of passive, single object passive, double object passive, command passive, question passive, auxiliary passive, dummy object passive, passive with additional information. And among these 7 passives, I completed 3 types, that is a single object, double object, then command passive. The remaining 4 types will be seen in the next class. Clear? And you are supposed to do your book pack exercises, which are covering these 3 methods. Okay, in page number 76 and 77, you are having book pack exercises also. Try to complete the exercises which are following this method. You are not asked to do complete all the voice exercises, whereas you are supposed to complete the method which I taught in today's class. Clear? And tomorrow you have a test in this voice section, and some few questions, 3 or 4 questions will be asked from the poem, that is all the words of stage. Clear? Thank you.